us about. Hey, let me talk to you for a minute. Come on and talk to us. All right, what we all doing is edifying our people, all right? And that's cool, that's cool you broadcasting and you looking and stuff like that, but we want to make sure you get the proper understanding. So come out here in the front. We got some pictures right here. Let me show you something. Let me show you something, all right? What's your name, by the way?
Ken Hartman.
Ken Hartman, Mr. Hartman, our brother Eli, all right? Nice to meet you, all right? All right, so now, Hartman says he made you an Israelite, all praise to the Most High. So as an Israelite, what do you think God required of you? What is your purpose on planet Earth?
To obey God's law.
To obey His
law,
right?
God's law and live by His
way. Live by His ways, right? Yeah. So now, if I show you the Bible.
And show His teachings as what you're doing. Show, you know, teach people
the right way.
Yeah.
So that's exactly what we're doing. Yeah. And that's the bottom line. In order for us to get to the kingdom, we have to learn what? The commandments, right? So now, let me show you a commandment real quick. Give me Habakkuk chapter 2 and verse 18. Habakkuk chapter 2 and verse 18. All right? The book of Habakkuk, chapter 2 and verse 18. All right? Listen up and listen good.
The book of Habakkuk, chapter 2 and verse 18.
Mm-hmm.
What profited the graven image that maketh thereof had graven it?
So now God says, what is the profit of a graven image? All right? You know what a graven image is?
Yes.
What is a graven image?
Graven image is something like this necklace or something like a statue or
right.
Anything like that that can play worship beside God, which you do not like.
Exactly, exactly. So God is asking the question. He said, listen, what is the purpose or what is the profit that you're going to get from wearing that cross? All right?
It's no profit, really.
Exactly. So listen, read them.
The mountain image and a teacher of lies.
So now he said, by you wearing that cross, it is a teacher of lies. All right, because the reason why it's a teacher of lies is because that cross was used to force our people to believe in what?
In
Christianity.
That's right.
All right, that image was used to enslave our people and make our people believe that this here, this image here, is Jesus Christ.
Which I know now.
All right, so you may know it, but our brothers and sisters may not know it.
Yeah. Right.
All right,
exactly.
And you being God's chosen people,
right.
God requires you to do what? Teach other people the knowledge that you know.
Right.
Right?
Right.
So by you walking around with a cross on,
right.
What are you doing?
Teaching them a false language.
Exactly. You're teaching them a false doctrine.
Yeah.
Because
right.
That's like you walking around, say your brother gets shot down by the M16, right?
Yeah.
And then you walk around with that M16 across your neck.
Yeah.
All right? Is that something that we need to glorify?
Nope.
No. So God said, what is the profit we didn't get?
The book of Habakkuk, chapter 2 and verse 18. What profited the graven image that the maker thereof had graven it?
So what's the profit of that thing? Why would you be wearing that? Read.
The molten image and a teacher of lies.
That cross is a teacher of lies.
Right.
All right, read.
That the maker of his work trusted therein to make dumb idols.
Those things are considered to be dumb idols.
Right.
So you may say, you know what, hey, I'm not bowing down to the cross. I'm not done going to worship in this day. Well, guess what comes with wearing that cross? This image here.
Right.
All right? Because our people associate the cross with this right here. Do they not?
Right.
Do they not?
Right.
Exactly. So now, what must we do to get our people to repent and come back to Jesus Christ? We got to teach them the what?
The word of life.
The truth. Give me John chapter 8 and verse 32. All right? Let me show you something. We got to teach our people the truth according to the Bible. Because the Bible says the graven image is a teacher of lies.
Right.
So in order to combat a lie, you must teach people what? The truth. All right? So let's find out what the truth is. Read that.
The book of St. John, chapter 8 and verse 32.
Come on.
And ye shall know the truth of.
Who's to you? Who's he talking to when he said, ye shall know the truth?
Talking to us.
The Israelites, right?
Right.
The so-called blacks, Hispanics, and the Americans.
Right.
He said, you Israelites. You should know the truth, read.
And the truth shall make you free.
And the truth shall set you free. So let's find out what the truth is according to the Bible. Give me John chapter 14 and verse 6. John chapter 14 and verse 6. Let's keep it right here. We're going to keep it in the New Testament. All right? So here's the truth according to the Bible. Because that cross is associated with this image, which is a lie, a teacher of lies.
Right.
All right? So let's see what Christ said. Read.
The book of St. John chapter 14 and verse 6.
Read.
Jesus said unto him.
Who said?
Jesus said unto him.
Jesus said unto him, read.
I am the way.
Christ said, I am the way.
Read. The truth.
The what?
The truth.
The what?
The truth.
The truth, read.
And the life.
And
Calvary. No man cometh unto the Father but by me.
But by me.
That's
now,
right.
We got to figure out who is the truth according to the Bible. Because we got two images here. All right? Christ said that he is the truth. Right. All right? So now, is this the true image of Christ? Let's find out. Give me that in Revelation chapter 1. All right? Because Christ said he's the truth, the way and the life. All right? And our job is to cast down all these lies about the graven images.
Right.
Because what comes with the cross, again, is this image here. This image here is what have our people destroyed as a nation. We believe that white man Jesus is going to save us from all our problems. We believe that white man Jesus is going to come out of the clouds and redeem everybody on planet Earth. Let's find out if this is true or not. Wait.
The book of Revelation, chapter 1 and verse 1.
Come on.
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
The word revelation, what did that mean?
Revelation?
Yeah.
Revelation.
All right, so the word revelation means to reveal. All right, the root word is in it, reveal, revelation.
Close to it.
Right, there you go. We're working with you, brother. All right, so you're right on the money. So now the word revelation means to reveal. So John the Revelator is about to reveal the truth about Jesus Christ.
Right.
Because Christ said he is the truth.
Right.
Read what you got.
Which God gave unto him to show unto his servant things which must surely come to pass.
So now, we are the servants of God, right? And our job is to show you what is going to come to pass.
Right.
What is going to come to pass today in 2020 is that you all, you so-called blacks, Hispanics, and Americans, you all going to learn the true image of your Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
That's right.
He's going to show you the truth because we are the servants of God.
That's right. And he sent and signified by his angel unto his servant John.
To his servant John. So now, we're about to reveal to you the true image of Jesus Christ according to the Bible. All right? Listen up and listen good. Jump down to verse 14.
The book of Revelation chapter 1 and verse 14.
Hey.
His head and his hairs were white like wool.
So now, just like the Bible says, those images that is posted up all in the churches, the images that we wear around our necks, all right? The images that we find inside our Bibles, in our history books, about Jesus Christ having blonde hair. God said his hair, Christ's hair, should be what?
White like wool.
Christ's hair is supposed to be white and woolly. You see?
Right.
Do this image here have white and woolly hair? So what is this image?
False.
A false image. It's a lie. All right? So that's strike one for this image, right? Christ has white, woolly hair. Read.
As white as snow.
Because he was full of wisdom. Come on.
And his eyes were a flame of fire.
So Jesus Christ had red eyes. All right? What was his first miracle? What was Christ's first miracle?
Red first miracle?
Yeah, what was it? At a wedding. What did he do at a wedding?
Oh, he turned water to wine.
There you go. He turned water into wine, right?
Right, right?
So usually at a wedding, you all drink at the wedding, right? We all drink at the wedding. So what happens when you drink wine? What happens to your eyes?
You get red.
It get a little tint, right? It get a little reddish, right? So Christ drank wine, but he wasn't a drunk. He drank in moderation.
Right.
So just the reason why his eyes was the color of fire.
Okay.
The prophecy proves that. Let's get that in Genesis chapter 49 and verse 12. All right, let's prove that. Because again, we out here doing, we're proving everything according to the Bible. All right? And we're casting out all these lies and imaginations. Imagination, the word image is in the word imagination. So we're casting down the false images of Jesus Christ. Read.
The book of Genesis, chapter 49 and verse 12.
Read.
His eyes shall be red with wine.
This is the prophecy about Jesus Christ being revealed in the last days. That's why the book of Revelation is called the book of Revelation, because it's revealing what Jesus Christ will look like when he comes back.
Right.
All right, so it says Christ's eyes should be red with wine. Because why? He drank wine in moderation. All right, read.
And his teeth white with milk.
All right, meaning he spoke the truth. So now let's go back to Revelation 1 and verse 14.
The book of Revelation chapter 1 and verse 14.
Huh?
His head and his hair were white like wool.
So your Messiah, our Messiah, has white woolly hair. It says not blonde and stringy. Read.
As white as snow.
Uh-huh.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
Why was his eyes the color of fire?
Wine.
Because he drank wine, right? Read.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
What kind of color is fine brass?
Brown,
right? But let's see how brown it is. Read.
As if they burned in a furnace.
As if there was burned in a furnace. So now, brother, if you take off the white pants and you burn in the furnace, what color's gonna come out? Exactly. If you take that cross and put it in the furnace, what color's gonna come out? So now that's why we are, because all our people want to do is play around, man. That's all they want to do. They want attention.
Right.
All right? Read. That read it again.
The book of Revelation, chapter 1, verse 15.
Read.
And his feet like unto fine brass.
So Christ's feet was the color of fine brass. How fine?
Read.
As if they burned in a furnace.
As if they was burned in a furnace. So my question to you is, if Jesus Christ's feet look like it was burned in a furnace, what do that make him? Does that make him this image?
No.
Or does that make him this image? So this image means Christ would be a what?
A
black man.
Yes,
Jesus Christ, the black Messiah, is the King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
That's
that
right.
Is coming back to destroy those that are not keeping his commandments.
That's
those
right.
That are taking his people into captivity. Understand that thing. Jesus Christ have always been a black man. And when he come back, he's going to continue to be a black man.
That's
understand
right.
That thing. So what are we proving? That your Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is black.
Right.
And guess what? Jesus Christ is from the tribe of Judah.
That's right.
You know who all else comes from the same tribe? The so-called blacks that's here in America.
That's right.
You all have the same blood running through your vein as Jesus Christ.
Right.
Understand that thing.
Right.
All right, so now what's your name again?
Dan Hartman.
Mr. Hartman. All right, so now, knowing that you're Israel, right? Knowing that your Lord and Savior is black, all right? You say that Christ wants us to do what again?
Live by his laws,
right?
Live by his way.
Exactly. So now, let me show you Deuteronomy chapter 7, verse 25. All right? Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 25. Let me show you something. Because we just read about the graven image, right? That cross is a graven image. All right? So let me show you what God says about that thing.
The book of Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 25. The graven images of the God shall ye burn with fire.
Is that not a graven image that you have in your neck? So God says, listen, that graven image that you have on your neck, you should do what?
Shall burn with fire.
You should burn it with fire.
Be it with someone else, but you know that it's over. It's too late.
Yeah. So now, do you love God?
I love God.
You love God?
You should get rid of
him. You should get rid of him. So as a sign of being obedient unto your Lord and Savior, what must you do with that cross right now?
You
got to
get rid of it.
You got to get rid of it, right?
Yeah.
So you're going to do it right now, or you're going to do it when you get home?
I'm going to do it when I go down the road.
All right, so now, obedience is better than sacrifice. You know that, right?
Yeah.
So what if Christ was to crack that sky right now
yeah.
and come down and say, you know what? Hey, it's going to be a wrap today,
right
now.
Right.
And you say, you know, I'm going to wait to do it when I get over there.
Right.
Where do you think you're going to be on the side when God comes back? What side do you think you're going to be on? You think you're going to be on
the other side.
Exactly. What's that other side?
Dealing with the devil.
You're going to be burnt the hell up.
Yeah.
All right. So now, again, what we're trying to do is get you, give me that in Acts chapter 3, verse 19. Let me show you what God is trying to get you to do. All right. You ain't doing it because I'm saying so. I want you to do it because God tells you to do it, and because you fear God.
See, I believe that, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, like, when I read the Bible, see, a lot of people, now, I want y'all to explain to me, because I always try to figure this out. A lot of people say that Christ was crucified on the cross, but in the Bible, it says that Christ was hung from a tree.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so, obviously, they must have hanged him.
They hung him on a cross.
They hanged him on a cross. I know in one of the verses, I forgot what chapter it is. It describes in two chapters where it say Christ was hanged from a tree.
Uh-huh.
It has the same cross in the Bible.
All right, then let me ask you this. Did he get hanged? Was he put to death? Did that happen, yes or no?
Yeah, he was put to death.
Exactly, so that's all that matters. Whether he was hung on a tree or whether he was hung on a cross, either way, it's dang on death for him. You
right.
see what I'm saying?
Right.
He fulfilled prophecy.
Right.
So that the point I'm making at is that's neither here nor there.
Right.
We got to deal with that image that you got on your
right.
neck.
Right.
Because God said that's a graven image, a teacher of lies.
Right.
All right? So now what we want you to do is this. Read that.
The book of Acts, chapter 3 and verse 19.
Come on, listen up and listen good.
Repent God ye therefore.
God says what?
Repent ye therefore.
God says for us to do what?
Repent.
Do what?
Repent.
Do what?
Repent.
So now, Brother Harper, I want you to do what? Repent. So now, in order for you to repent, you have to know what sin is, right?
Right.
So having that graven image across your neck is a what? Sin. Right. All right? Do you know what sin is?
Yes.
What is sin?
Like got the
grim
card not provided by God
law. Alright, so let's find out if that's what the Bible says. 1 John 3 and 4. Let's find out if that's what the Bible says, alright? Because we have people who may be watching online may not know exactly what the definition is.
Right.
So we want to make sure we give them the proper understanding. Alright? 1 John 3 and 4. Say again?
The book of 1 John chapter 3 and verse 4.
Come on.
Whosoever committed sin.
Those of you that commit sin. What are you doing?
Transgressing also the law.
You are breaking God's law.
Right.
For sin is the transgression of the law.
So now I want you to give me Romans 6 and 23. So now you know what sin is, right? So what is sin?
Breaking God's law.
Breaking of God's laws, right? So now, what is the punishment for breaking God's laws? Hell. Yeah. Let's find out what the Bible says.
Read the book of Romans chapter 6 and verse 23.
Come on.
For the wages of sin
for the penalty. Read it again.
The book of Romans chapter 6 and verse 23. For the wages of sin.
For the wages of sin, the penalty for breaking God's commandment is what?
Is death.
Is death. So now my question to you, Mr. Harper, do you want to be put to death? All right, so now what must you do? You got it by doing what?
Getting rid of the image.
So now, are you going to do that right now?
Yeah, I'm going to get rid of it.
Psalms 119, verse 59. Psalms 119, verse 59. Psalms 119, verse 59. Because I got to show you, I'm trying to get somewhere with you. Yeah. I know you got a zeal for God,
yeah.
All right? But I want you to understand how serious this is,
yeah.
All right? Because a lot of times what we tend to do is, as growing up in Christian church, or any kind of other religion, we've been taught that, you know what, we got all the time in the world to repent. You see what I'm saying?
No.
Is that true, right? We don't have that. We don't have all the time in the world, right? So now, let's find out how fast you should be doing what you're doing. Psalms 119 and verse 50.
The book of Psalms chapter 119 and verse 59.
Come on.
I thought on my ways.
So David thought on his ways, come on.
And turned my feet unto thy testimony.
So he turned to keeping God's commandments. Read.
I made haste.
And he made haste, meaning he hurry up. Read.
And delay not to keep thy commandments.
And he didn't waste time to keep the commandments.
Right.
So likewise, you should do the same, right?
Right.
So now, when we tell you that the cross is a teacher of lies,
right.
All right, the graven image, God says you have to take that off and burn it, right?
Right.
Then he turned right around and tell you that you have to make haste.
Right.
Meaning you have to what? Hurry up
right.
to do it. So now, again, are you going to hurry up and take it off right now? Or you going to take your chance on dang on getting caught up in a lake of fire?
I'm gonna get back where I got it.
So let's see if you love God. All right? Brother, if you love God, take that cross off right now.
Yes, right.
Take it off right now.
Yeah.
That's where repentance is, right there. All praise to the Most High.
Yeah.
All the praises. So was that hard to do?
Yeah.
All right, so now let's give me that 1 John 5 and 3. Let me show you something. What you did is repentance.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying? So that's not hard, right?
That's right.
All right, so now let me show you what the Bible says. 1 John 5 and 3. All right? 1 John 5 and 3. Listen up and listen good. The book of 1 John, chapter 5 and verse 3.
The book of 1 John, chapter 5 and verse 3.
Mm-hmm.
For this is the love of God.
So now we're about to show you what love means according to the Bible.
Read. That we keep.
That we what?
That we keep.
That we what?
That we keep.
This is the love of God, that we, the Israelites, keep
his commandments.
Keep his commandments.
Read. And his commandments are not grievous.
And his commandments, meaning grievous, means not hard.
Yes.
So now, was it hard to take that cross off? Easy. So that means you can keep any of the commandments. You see how easy that was?
Right.
Let me give you one more commandment. One more commandment. Give me 1 Corinthians 11 and 3. One of the brothers, one of y'all come up. That's 30 minutes. All right, one of y'all get ready to come on up. All right, because we edifying Brother Harper.
Hartman.
I don't know why I'm going to say Hartman. Hartman. All right.
Yeah.
Listen up and listen good.
Yeah.
Hey. The
The book of 1 Corinthians chapter 11 and verse 3.
Uh-huh.
But I will have you know that the head of every man is Christ.
No, he said the head of every man is Christ. Read.
And the head of the woman is the man.
And the head of the woman is the man. You got an old lady? You got a friend. Okay, okay. We're going to get to that in a second, too. So you got an old lady. You got a friend, right? All right. So now, he said, God says the head of the woman is you. So you're ahead of her. Three.
And the head of Christ is God.
And the head of Christ is God. So let me break it down for you real simple. What God is simply saying is this. You have the Most High God.
Right.
You have Christ. You have man. Then the woman.
Right.
That's the divine order that God has set up.
Right.
All right. So now, Christ has to answer to who?
He has to
answer to
God.
He has to answer to God.
Right.
We as men, who do we have to answer to?
Christ.
Christ. And the woman have to answer to who?
Man.
There you go. Right. So you got that easy in. All right, all praise. Read.
Every man praying or prophesizing.
Now, what you're doing right here, Mr. Hartman, is you're in the midst of prophecy. All right? When the word of God is being spoken or being taught, that's called prophesying.
Right.
So we prophesy. You agree?
I agree.
All right, read.
Having his head covered.
So now, he said, if a man is in the midst of prophesying and he have his head covered, he have something on his head.
Dishonoring his head.
So now, who is your head?
My head. Christ.
Your Christ is Christ.
That's
so
right.
By you having that hat on your head, you are dishonoring who?
Christ.
Christ. So what must you do, Mr. Hartman? All praise. All praise. You have to come back. All right. All right. All praise. All praise. All praise.